Are you having the splash screen when you're trying to capture your display in OBS Studio or Streamlabs OBS? Well, I'm going to show you how to fix it coming up next in this OBS tutorial. So I get this issue when I'm on a laptop and I'm trying to capture my display. And this is actually really easy to fix. So let's go ahead and exit out of Streamlabs, and we will need a desktop shortcut. So if you do not already have one of those, go down to your start menu and scroll down to OBS or Streamlabs, and then go ahead and right click on the program, go over to more, and then go down to open file location, and you will see Streamlabs OBS highlighted here. Go ahead and right click on this and then go to create shortcut. And this will create a shortcut on your desktop right now. And now that we have a shortcut on our desktop, what we will want to do is go ahead and right click on the program. And I'll open up this menu. And then the second option down is run with graphics processor. We will want to go to the right arrow and then go to integrated graphics default. Let's go ahead and select this option right here. And it's going to go ahead and open Streamlabs OBS on your integrated graphics. And when you do this, you will see your display captured in Streamlabs OBS now. Now, if you want Streamlabs OBS to open up with your integrated graphic card all the time, if you go to Streamlabs OBS and right click it, go back to run with graphics processor, and then go to change default graphics processor, it's going to go ahead and open up the NVIDIA control panel, where we will have the option under number 2 to change from high performance NVIDIA processor to integrated processor. And once we have that selected and go to apply, it's going to change our default processor. So every time we open up OBS now, we won't have to go back and right click it and go to run with graphics processor and go to integrated graphics. However, you may have some issues with this. It seems like for me, it doesn't open up with Streamlabs OBS as the default. However, when I go ahead and change the default graphics processor in OBS Studio, I can open up this program all the time without having to right click it and go to run with graphics processor and then go to integrated graphics. I'm not sure why that is. It should change over your default graphics processor for you guys. And if this video did indeed help you out fix your black screen issues with your display on OBS, go ahead and leave this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below for more OBS tutorials coming up next on Your Six Studios.